Hello everyone, this is Dr. Jameel Ahmed Mullah and I welcome you all to my channel Enrich Knowledge with Dr. Jameel. Today's topic is Vancouver Citing and Referencing Style. I have seen many students facing difficulty while preparing list of references, especially when it is their first review or research article. Usually, we need a referencing in research and review articles, thesis writing, preparing poster for presentations, seminar and webinar presentations, for assignment, etc. Before I begin, please subscribe this channel, press bell icon and set bell notification to all to get more videos on pharmaceutical sciences and study related topics. So let's begin. The Vancouver Citing and Referencing Style. There are different methods are available for the citing and referencing in scientific papers. So among them, there is a one method, the Vancouver Citing. So Vancouver is a numbered referencing style commonly used in medicine and science, and it consists of citation to someone else's work in the text, indicating by the use of a number. A sequentially numbered reference list at the end of the document providing full details of the corresponding in-text reference. It follows rules established by the International Committee of Medical Journal Editors. Now it is maintained by the US National Library of Medicine, that is NLM. It is also known as uniform requirement for the manuscript submitted to the different biomedical journals. So let us see about this in-text citation. So how we are going to insert in-text citation? When your work has been influenced by someone else's work, for example, when you directly quote someone else's work, or when you paraphrase someone else's work, then you are going for the citation. So here there are some of the general rules for in-text citation. A number is allocated to a source in the order in which it is cited in the text. If the source is referred to again, the same number is used. Use Arabic numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Either square or curved brackets can be used as long as it is consistent. Superscripts can also be used rather than bracket. For example, if it is a text ended with the was discovered, in the superscript you can see 1, 3. The reference list at the end we are writing. References are listed in a numerical order and in the same order in which they are cited in the text. The reference list appears at the end of the paper. Begin your reference list on a new page and title it as a references. The reference list should include all and only those references you have cited in the text. Use Arabic numerals like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Yeah. In this Vancouver style, we are going to use the abbreviated journal title. The link is given in the description how we can go for the writing the abbreviated form of this journal titles. So let us begin with the first example. if you referred the some of the material or the text in terms of the journal, then how you are going to cite and you are going to write in the references. So here this is the articles in the journal. So the format, so the author, or you can have the more than one author. So we are going to start with the surname followed by the initial full stop, then title of the article full stop, name of the journal full stop, year semicolon, volume into bracket issue colon page number. So this is standard format when we referred any articles in the journal. Let us see one example. Suppose you have referred something on the other article, or you suppose you derived some of the material from some articles. Say for example, here I have quoted one example. Many review articles have already focused on the applications of the antibacterial and anti-cancer agent. You can see I have cited one in a square bracket, and therefore this review states that the text is continued. So here that is how we are going to cite in a text, that is insight in text citation. So at the end we are going to write this reference in the Vanker style. So you can see here, this is the format, that is the author's name. So here we can find the reference number, that is what the reference number we are cited in the text, that is in text citation. So this is number one, and we can see this is the author's name, that is surname and initials. We can find there's a Mullah JS, the Mullah is the surname, then the initial comma, then second author comma third author. Once you complete all the author's name, you have to go to the put the full stop. Then we are going to write the title of the article, development of the respirable rifampicin loaded nanolipomer composites by microemulsion spray drying for the pulmonary delivery. After the title we are going to put the full stop. Then we can find the, we are going to write the abbreviated name of the journal, J dot drug delivery dot science dot technology. It is Journal of Drug Delivery and Science and Technology, followed by we are written that is a year, followed by semicolon, volume. Yeah, sometime you may find the issue will be there after the volume, or sometime you find only the volume. If the issue is there, then you can write after the volume issue, otherwise after the volume you are going to put the colon, then later the page numbers from 13 to 19 full stop. So this is one example, that is when we referred any material or you derived some text from articles in the journal. So this is the standard format, that is how you are going for the citing in the text, as well as at the end how you are going to write a reference as a Vanker style. If there are more than six authors, list the first six authors followed by et al. For example, you can see here the author's name 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So after that, still some more author's name are here. So after six author's name, so you are going to put the et al. Full stop. Then yeah, you can see the author's surname initial comma et al. Full stop, followed by again the similar way, the title of the article, the abbreviated name of the journal, year, volume, issue. You can see here volume into bracket issue colon page numbers. Suppose if you have derived some of the text or the some reference from the book and other monographs, then this is the standard format. The author or the more than one author, authors, we can say authors of the book, surname, initial, full stop, title of the book, full stop, edition, full stop, place of publication, colon, publisher, semicolon, year of publication, full stop, page number, full stop. Let us see the one example. You can see here, this is the reference of one textbook, Lachman L, Lieberman HA. This is the author's name. Each author name is followed by the comma. Now once you complete all author's name, you have to put the full stop. Then the title of the book, The Theory and Practice of Industrial Pharmacy, full stop. Edition, third edition. The place of publication followed by colon, that is Mumbai colon. Here we can find the publisher followed by semicolon, year of publication and the page numbers. So when you are going to refer the any textbook or the reference book, so it start with the small p letter, dot, then page number. In article we are giving the page number, all the page numbers of the particular article, whereas in a textbook when you are going to refer, so which page number you refer, sometime one page, sometime the two pages, sometime three pages, so that page number we have to write prefixing with the small letter p. You can see here 182 to 184, these are the pages they are referred. Then comma, again from 296 to 303, so these pages they have referred. Again 311 to 312 pages they have referred. So here in a textbook when are going to quote the page number, so specific page number we have to mention again with prefix letter p. Again in the same format for the book reference, if you are going to write a reference for the chapter or the article in a book, sometime so what we discussed in the previous case, it is about the one author, or we can say that 2-3 author will be there for a one textbook, whereas there are some books where each chapter is going to be contributed by the some of the authors. So in that case, how we are going to go for the referencing? So this is the format: authors of the chapter, again surname, initial, full stop, title of the chapter, dot, in colon, editor's name, comma, we have to write the editors, full stop, title of the book, full stop, edition, dot, place of publication, colon, publisher, semicolon, year of publication, dot, page numbers, full stop. You can see one example. So here we can find the authors for this chapters. The authors' name are here, the Roberts, Morrow. So they are the authors for the chapter, analgesic, antipyretic and anti-inflammatory agents and drugs employed in the treatment of gout. So this is the title of the chapter. Then you are going to write in colon editor's name. Here you can find the editor's name followed by ED, in short for the editors, full stop. Then title of the book, Goodman and Gilman's The Pharmacological Basis of Therapeutics, followed by edition, that is 10th edition, full stop, place of publication, New York, colon, McGraw-Hill, that is a publisher, semicolon, year, full stop, 2001, yeah, page numbers, prefix with small letter P, full stop, 687 to 732. So this is the referencing of books where the chapters are going to be contributed by the different authors. Now suppose you, if you are referred some of the website and the some content if you have derived for your work, then this is the format how you are going to refer or how you are going for the references. Author surname, that is initial, if available. Sometime you find on the website the author name may be there or may not be there. If it is there, then you can write the surname followed by the initial, full stop. Title of the website, into square bracket you have to write the internet, full stop. Place of publication, colon, publisher, semicolon. Date of first publication, into bracket, date of last update, semicolon, cited date, complete the bracket, full stop, available from URL, www, and so on. So here the important aspect, the date of first publication you can find on the website, that has to be written. Then the date of last update, that also you can find, plus the cited date, that is on which date you have accessed that particular website, that is at the time of reference. So you have to write the that particular date, that is a cited date. For example, you can see here, so this is the title of the website. Here we didn't find the author name, so directly we can go for the title of the website. Solid lipid nanoparticles, into square bracket, internet, full stop. Then place of publication, USA, colon. Then publisher, LLS health management team, colon. Year, that the date of publication, and into bracket you can find it is updated on 31st August 2020. So this is the format. Year you have to write 2020 August 31st date, colon. Then cited date, that is when we have accessed that particular data. So cited, year, month and date. So 2021 year, July month and 13 is the date, complete the bracket, full stop. Then available from colon URL, you can see this is the link of the particular website. So this is the format for the website. When you referred any website and you derived some content from the particular website, and this is the format for the referencing that particular site. Suppose if you referred some of the patents, and if you derived some content from the particular patent, and this is the format, that is how you can go for the referencing. So here the inventors, semicolon, assignee, full stop, title, full stop, patent country, document, patent country, the document type, country code, patent number, dot, date issued. So here you can find in the patents there are two types of the authors. So one, we can find the inventors, maybe more than one inventor or inventors of the device, process or other entity being patented. And the assignees are nothing but the organization or the individuals holding the legal title of the patent. So here the patent have the two types of the authors. So one, we can find the inventors, the second will be the assignee. So the inventor, that is the inventor for the device, process or any other entity being for the patented, whereas the assignee, these are the organization or the individuals that hold the legal title of the patent. Let us see the explanation on this example. So the tailor and other authors, you can find, that is the inventors. So So after writing of this author name, so we have to write inventors semicolon, then assignee, that is the organization. You can find this is the Sharp, Kabushiki, Kaisha, comma assignee, full stop. Then you are going to write the title, it is a nanoparticles, full stop. Then here you can find the patent country, that is a United States. Document type, it is a patent. Then country code, it is a US. Then patent number 8552417, full stop. Then date issued, it is 8th of October 2013. So you have to write in this format year, month and date. So this is the format for the patent referencing. That means when you are referred any patent and you derived some content, and this is the method for the referencing. Hope you have learned how to insert citation in text and proper way of listing references at the end of any script. I'll be coming with more such kind of videos. Till then, have a good time. Thank you for watching.